Jay from WaterIce.com with another edition of Street Scoop. And St. Patrick's Day is right around the corner. What better place to talk about St. Patrick's Day than here at McGillin's Old Ale House? Now, we're going to talk to our owner and the manager, Chris Mullen, just talk about St. Patrick's Day, what this bar means to Philadelphia, and maybe get some celebrity stories. So let's go check it out and see what McGillin's is all about. Well, now, this is the absolute oldest bar in Philadelphia. Is this correct?
That is correct. Without doubt, we are the oldest. No one can claim our age. We're 155 years old.
Awesome. And apparently, it is also the fifth oldest?
That's right. Yep.
In the U.S.?
In the United States. The fifth oldest bar in the United States. That's correct.
That's awesome. Like, how did it survive the Prohibition era?
Well, officially, what happened when Prohibition was enacted, Catherine McGillin, who was the owner at the time, she locked these front doors and put the key in her breast pocket and said, I'll keep these doors locked until Prohibition was over. I think she thought that it was going to last maybe a few months. I think the United States thought it was only going to last a few months. Right. Well, after time, they realized it wasn't going away, so they let people in through the side door. And may or may not have served cocktails in teacups.
Right.
But officially, we partnered with a farm from New Jersey and did like dairy, ice cream, sandwiches. It was more of a restaurant.
Okay, cool. So can you just give like a brief history of how McGillin's came to play in Philadelphia?
Yeah, absolutely. In 1860, William McGillin's opened his tavern here. When he opened it, he called it the Bell in Hand.
Okay.
And originally, it was just one row home that was pretty much the center of the building here. He opened a bar on the first floor and raised his family on the second floor.
Okay.
As his business began to grow, and his family also increased in size. He had 13 children. They bought the properties on either side of the bar.
Okay.
And he died in 1901, and his wife, Catherine, took over the operation of the bar. And she was pretty much the most famous female barkeep in all of the city. They continued to live upstairs, and it was a very successful, very famous bar even in its time.
Cool.
She named it McGillin's after her husband.
Okay.
And my grandfather purchased it in 1958.
Awesome.
And it's been in my family ever since.
Very cool. I love history. So that, to me, that's awesome. All right. So St. Patty's Day is right around the corner. Can you tell me how important this bar is to Philly, especially in the Irish community?
Well, all bars are important to the people in the Irish community, so there's no doubt about that. We're one of many, but we are the oldest. We're founded by Irish Americans, and it's been owned by Irish Americans, except for when my grandfather owned it. He's Polish, but we brought it back to the Irish heritage. And I think everybody longs for the experience that maybe your grandfather had, you know, your relatives had. And here at McGillin's, we try to give people that feel. You know, we're home away from home. We're not fancy. There's no pretenses here. And your dollar goes far, you know. So we want you to have fun. We want your family to bring your family. We want to make this a, you know, a place where everyone can have a good time. So from grandparents to children to their grandchildren. And I think that's important part of our success.
Cool. Can you just explain some of the beer drafts you have on tap here?
Sure. So we have 30 beers on draft, and we specialize in local beers. So out of the 30 lines, 26 of them are from within 90 miles. So we sell most of our beer comes from Stout's Brewery, which is out in Adamstown, Pennsylvania, Yards and Philly Brewing and Do Good and Flying Fish and all the breweries that we have come to love here in Philadelphia, you can always find here on draft. The other thing is all of our pints are under $5. So for some places you're paying $8 for a pint of beer. That's will never happen here at McGillin. So we try to keep our prices down, give you a nice variety, and pair with some good food at reasonable prices.
Sure, sure. I know. You may be got to be politically correct on this, but I just want to know, for somebody that's coming into the bar, they may not know what to get. There's so many beers on tap. What would you recommend?
We always start with our sampler. So this way, you want to try beers that are local. It's a good way to start. You get 6 10-ounce pours for $9. It's an awesome value, and you get to sample 6 different breweries. And then we also are always more than willing to say, you know what, I'm not ready to commit.
Yeah.
Just we'll give you a little sample. So it's our job to help educate beer drinkers, especially because we do get so many people from out of town as well, so they may not be familiar with any of our breweries.
Right.
So this gives people a chance to try what we have.
Very cool, very cool. Also, can you just talk about the cuisine here?
Sure. It's bar food. Yeah. So again, no pretenses. We make a great cheesesteak, awesome nachos. We do entrees. We have steaks and seafood and things like that. But it's not fancy. Very reasonable. Just about every night of the week, we have great food specials too. Like tonight, you're here on a Wednesday night, and we do $3 nachos. So it's great. And then we do free soup at lunch too, because this has always been a lunch destination as well. So to help just continue that, we offer a complimentary soup from our self-serve kettle.
Sure. I think location has to do a lot with how well it's been going. Can you just elaborate on why it works, why McGillin's works here in Philadelphia?
I think it works because we care. We're a family business. One of us is always here on the property. We care about what we do very much, and I think you feel that when you come to McGillin's. Location, frankly, works in our favor now, but 10 years ago, this was probably the roughest part of town. So, we've always been somewhat of a destination. We're in a back alley. You really have to know where you're going to find us. So we have to work a little extra hard just to make sure that people come through our door. And then once they're in the door, they have a great time.
I think it helps that it's in an alley because it's kind of cool. A little.
Yeah, but, before cell phones, right. You could be walking around for hours and never find it,
sure.
You know?
Sure. I guess if there's any special events coming up this year or coming up pretty soon, do you want to talk about that?
Yeah, absolutely. Well, this is the peak of our season. So on Saturday, it's the citywide pub crawl day. So everybody's bar hopping all over town, and Sunday's St. Patrick's Day parade, and Tuesday's St. Patrick's Day, and then from there we get into Cinco de Mayo and summer events, and it's a real fun time to be here.
Awesome. Thank you so much for doing this.
Oh yeah, thank you guys. No, it's fun. Come back and see some more of it.
Good food and good beer.
Thank you.
Thanks. And there you have it, Philly. McGillin's Old Ale House here on Drury Street in Center City, Philadelphia. Come on down for St. Patty's Day. It's going to be a lot of fun, a great atmosphere. And I hope you enjoyed this piece. On behalf of WaterIce.com, I'm Jay, your scoop to everything Philly.